Hey guys, this is Leathercraft 209. I wanted to post a quick video update for a client who ordered a custom tool pouch. And so I figured I'd post on YouTube for him to view. But also, if anyone's interested in something like this, you can contact me. My website and information will be in the description. So really quick, this is a custom tool pouch for Javier. He sent me his tools and his pouch. And so the idea was to kind of make a version of this in leather that was more durable, that held his tools a little bit better, you know, so they didn't go falling out everywhere. And so this is, if you can see, this is sideways, and yeah, it does pretty well. So really quick, let me just go over the design. At first, when I was trying to make this pouch, I was trying to do what this pouch does, which is, and it's kind of hard to explain, but basically, so they have one big pouch here and multiple pockets here, and then another pouch here, which held a lot of the tools, I think. And then, like, the glove strap and the utility knife. So I was trying to kind of do this tiered system where it was kind of layers. And as I was doing that, when you use leather and you try to do this, it starts to really bulk up. Like, it starts to really get wide. When you try to account for all the tools, it just makes a huge bulge with leather. And, you know, accounting for the gussets. You know, when you have nylon or, I think it's nylon, you know, and you can kind of have this squishy gusset and it expands and contracts. With leather, it will do that to some degree, but for the most part, you know, you want to form it that way and then form another pouch on top of that, you know. So anyway, I wasn't happy with that. I tried to do it a couple times and all the times it came out really bulky. It started to look really bulky, and so I ended up scrapping it. So this is kind of the design I decided to go with. It's a really clean look. Everything is held tightly, so you probably can't tell, but so this will be hanging on your belt. But, you know, this is sideways, like, you know, sideways to the floor right now, right? And so stuff is not falling out. Now, I mean, obviously, if I hung it upside down, stuff would probably fall out slowly. Well, that thing will, right? But, I mean, for the most part, when it's packed in there, it's packed in there pretty good. Now, of course, it will stretch and mold a little bit. So let me go over the design really quick. Let me get really close here. So this first one is for the long knife blade. And it's kind of designed like a knife sheath. This is how I design knife sheaths. Now, the blade doesn't go all the way to the bottom. There's a little bit of space right here. Just in case you decide to get a different size knife or whatever. And at the same time, if you get a shorter blade for some reason, you know, this design with that handle, like, it holds it there, you know. So you can wear it like that with the handle out, or you could put it in that way, you know. Now, I don't know how high this will ride up onto your belt, but I think the most comfortable would probably be that way. So yeah, so this is kind of a knife sheath style for this blade. So the second part is this little pouch right here, and I'll explain that on the back part in just a second. This is for the putty knife, and you can see this strip of leather right here. Now, most of this is made with oil tan, right, which is a kind of a soft leather right here. And my concern with the putty knife specifically was because it does have an edge to it, that is, if you were trying to do that here, right, that you would start to get, I mean, you probably wouldn't cut it because this leather is pretty durable, but it would really start to stretch out, you know. And so what I wanted to do is kind of do a reinforcer. This is two layers of leather right here, and then it runs all the way down, right? So on this front patch, there's another layer of leather right here, other than this one. So basically, it just makes it easy to slip in and out. And you can see right now, it rests right where the handle comes in. It will actually go deeper if you wanted to. Let me bow that out right there, see? So now the blade is at the bottom. But it's really designed to kind of sit right there. And the handle basically provides the stop, you know. But if you need to shove it in further, or if you got a longer blade on a different putty knife, there is still about 3/4 inch space, maybe 1/2 inch. But you could add a longer blade. Now I did try to make some allowance for width, but I wanted to be careful with that because you start to get a really wide pouch. So that's the putty knife section. So let me show you this really quick. this is one whole pouch, and then on each edge are two loops. So let me show you. The ruler and the level basically are free in their own, in the middle section right here. Let me see if I can get this to be brighter. Yeah, okay. And then what I did was I formed a loop right here for this bar. And now this loop, let me separate the sheath really quick. Right, so that loop is just stitched onto this gusset right here. This loop only goes down about 3 inches, well, maybe 2 inches. Right, so at 2 inches it stops. So if you accidentally put something in there and it fell down, you could actually reach in there and grab it out. Is this basically meant to just keep the rod on this side? Right, so it doesn't go all the way over there. But anyway, it is, yeah, there's a it only goes to about 2 inches, and so if you needed to, you know, pull a rod out of it, you could. The pencil pouch, on the other hand, I decided to do closed because I was afraid that you would lose pencils at some point. So it is still, it's a pretty tight fit right now. So hopefully you can see that. There's another loop right there. And that goes the full length of this gusset. Move this aside a little bit. Right there. It goes all the way down. And the idea of it is, like I said, it's friction mounted right now. So like, you know, if you had a short pencil, you won't really need to worry about it, you know, falling into it. But over time, if this starts to become loose, you know, you should stick with using the back section, which I'll show you in just a second. So yeah, so this is about right. Your pencil is a little bit shorter. I do have another contractor pencil, which is almost new. So you can see, and when you shove that in there, all the way down to the bottom. Yeah, so that's right at the bottom. You can kind of feel it. So that much sticks out like on a new pencil. Okay? Just to give you an idea. But once your pencil starts to get super short, I'll show you the next pouch I made for that later in a second. Alright, so the next section... Oh, let me move this out the way too. The next piece is kind of designed to be also like a sheath. Kind of like a scabbard, like a sword scabbard that, you know, sword goes into, or a knife would go into. And the reason for that is, you know, I noticed on your old pouch, you had worn a hole. And my guess is, because I have a utility knife like this too, and I put it down and put it away a lot, where a little bit of the blade is still hanging out. So, you know, sometimes we'll retract the blade, but we'll forget that a little bit of it's still coming out, or you know, we're just in a hurry, and we'll stick in the pouch. So the design for this is to kind of mimic the knife sheath idea. And you can kind of see, it does this kind of teardrop shape because I attached it over here. I didn't want to attach it like this one, mostly because it was so large. So I wanted to keep the size slim without having to extend the case out any further. I mean the pouch out any further. So if you look at it, it's tear-shaped, and the idea is that if for some reason, not that I recommend this, but if you had the blade out and you put it away, you know, basically what you would see is this little crevice, I guess, that's the best way to describe it, a little crevice that basically the knife blade would go in, and you really, it wouldn't cut anything major, it wouldn't cut the thread. It would probably just scratch up, you know, the back part of the sheath right here. And that's the other piece, is it wouldn't cut this, right? It would cut into like a really small corner in the back over there, right? So even if the blade was out and you put it in that way, all the blade is doing is running against this leather. Now this is two layers of leather, so it's the oil tan that I used before. But it's also a layer of this, but it's the rough side. And the reason that for that is the rough side just seems to hold up better to cuts. For whatever reason, it just does. So, you know, when you make a knife sheath, for example, the smooth side on a traditional knife sheath, of the, you know, the smooth side of leather is always showing out, mostly for looks, but also because it just happens that it deals with knife edges better. So once again, you could put it in like this, and this is the way I would probably try to do it. Now, right now it's going to be a tight fit because obviously this is all brand new. It hasn't been broken in. And so what I found is if you do it this way, more of it actually sinks into it, you know, into the case. But it's, you know, your choice, however you want to pull out the utility knife. And once you break it in, now I did stitch this way, right there, and close it up a little bit so that it wasn't a fully open bottom. But I did want to leave a little gap here in case you do put it away with the blade extended. You'll see that it goes down to right about there, you know, to that point. And you're not really going to cut anything. You know, same thing if you put it in this way. Now, obviously the blade would, you know, when you're pulling it out, it will rub against the spine right here on the inside. But once again, it's a really durable, thick, two layers of leather that we need to go through. So it would take a long time for that to actually do any damage, mostly because of the design. All right, so let me go over. Oh, and there's a gusset right here. You know, I just stitched a little, it's a square box thingy to make this. All right, next is the backside. Really quick. This is a 3-inch elastic pouch. It's sealed at the bottom. It's for the gloves. I know we wanted to put the gloves in the front, but you know, I couldn't really. One option was to put it here, one option was to put it here, but I couldn't really think of a nice way of putting it, the way the case still looked, you know, pretty functional. So anyway, my thought is, you know, once you have this, if you have this on your belt loop, that after about a week or two of, you know, carrying it this way, you'll probably get used to it. But it is a nice secure hold. You can just shove them in, however, you know, not really worry about it. And since it's against your thigh, or, you know, it'll be against, you know, your leg, the chance of this the gloves coming out are actually slim to none. But, you know, I mean, it depends how well you shove them in there, obviously. And then, so that's that pouch, and then over here is another small pouch. And I'll just show you really quick. It's only about 3 inches. That's the bottom of it right there. And so about 3 inches, and basically it's just designed for once your pencils get shorter, you can shove them in. So right about, you're almost at the end right there. So you can see this, so about 3 inches of it, well, probably like 2.5 inches of it are inside. And then, you know, however many inches you want to stick out. Now, of course, you can always use this one. As long as this is tight, you really don't have to worry about the pencil sliding in. If the pencil does slide in, you probably have to use some needle nose pliers or some, they call them medical clamps. They're kind of look like scissors, but they're clamps at the end. You might have to use something like that to get the pencil out. But just to load it back up and show you how I would put it. Alright, so there's the tool pouch. It's still nice and compact. I was really trying to keep it to this size. You can see I came pretty close. I did add maybe an inch to that side. And height-wise, I think I kept it almost exactly the same height. I was truly trying to keep this size down for you because you don't really want a huge, you know, a huge wide pouch hanging off your belt. Oh, one other thing I forgot to talk about was this leather. So this is two layers of 6 to 7 ounce leather. So if you look at this, let me see if I can get this. If you look at this leather, it is basically the same thickness as one of these pencils. I mean, this thing is pretty thick. And along this edge where it meets with this leather, you know, it's three layers of leather, and I did burnish it and try to smooth it up a little bit right here. It is harder to smooth because the elastic is there, right? And this leather oil tan does not take water well. It does not accept water, so it's really hard to get a nice smooth edge on the leather. Stuff is falling out, but yeah, you can see the case was actually upside down at that moment. Anyway, so yeah, that's a really thick piece of leather once you account for two layers of the 6 ounce, the knife sheath leather and the elastic coming together, right? Nice thick edge, it's solid. But yeah, this belt loop, I mean, it is, you can't really bend it a whole lot. I mean, it will break in over time, but you can see that, yeah, 6 to 7 ounce in two layers has some good thickness to it. All right, Javier, if you have any questions, let me know. If you're watching this video and you're interested in a custom tool pouch, my information to my website will be in the description along with my blog. Please comment, follow, subscribe, email me if you want something custom made for your tools. All right, guys, take care.